Bryan Nehman with you here on this Tuesday morning. Going to do something a little bit different here on the news, but we're going to make some news maybe because the governor is in the house. Governor Larry Hogan, pleasure to have you here. Thanks for coming
in. Thank you. It's great to be with you.
Listen, I know the General Assembly session is winding down a couple of weeks, and you'd like a lot of things to happen in that time frame. I did want to get your thoughts on what exactly you want to do for school safety, because that is obviously in the headlines right now. When you look at the big picture, do you want this to be, whatever happens, to be uniform for every school in the state of Maryland, or do you want this for each individual school district to have their choices on how to handle it?
Well, it's a little bit of both. So we want to have some statewide standards that have to be met at a minimum, but then we want to give flexibility to the schools to, you know, implement it in the best way that they see fit for their school systems. Right now, it's kind of hit or miss. We have some really great school safety programs, like in St. Mary's County, where they had a terrific school resource officer that did his job and saved a lot of kids from potentially being shot. And then we have other places where we don't have school resource officers. We have almost no security. And so our proposal was to take money from the casino revenues in a lockbox to make sure we're spending that money on schools and take a portion of that, $4.4 billion, and put it into school safety, $125 million of improvements like, better locks and cameras and doors and windows being more secure, metal detectors if school systems want to do that, and then $50 million a year for additional mental health counselors and school resource officers.
Would you like to have a school officer in every single school?
I think it would be great if we could do that. I think that would make a lot of sense. And having one really well-trained armed officer really can stop many of these tragedies from happening.
But not mandated that every school would have it.
It's not going to be mandated, but we're going to try to give them the resources to be able to do it if they want to.
What about some schools that are big? I mean, Great Mills was a pretty big school. You know, you've got obviously some giant schools in Montgomery County and Anne Arundel County, Baltimore County.
Sure.
Multiple school officers, school resource officers?
I think that's for the local jurisdictions to decide. But like Great Mills had one guy. He happened to be a really well-trained SWAT officer who did his job and was able to save kids. Montgomery County, by the way, we had a potential incident. But, you know, we say if you see something, say something. Mm-hmm. Kids said they were concerned. A parent raised the flag, and mental health counselors were involved. They got the police involved, and they went and arrested a kid that had an AR-15 assault weapon in his house and was threatening to shoot up a school in Montgomery County.
It is a fine line, right, on having these schools being open and keeping the kids safe and not having them look like prisons. There are people who would like to have magnetometers at every single school. I mean, is that something you see, or is that too far?
I'm concerned about, we don't want kids to feel unsafe going to school. We also don't want an environment that feels like they're in lockdown all the time. So you got to find that happy medium between those, making sure we can do things that keep them safer, that our response time is better, we have better cameras, without it being locked down so you feel like you're in a prison.
You are, though, against arming teachers.
Yeah, I thought that was a kind of a dumb idea. But having a trained officer in there that's armed, I think, is a good idea.
Where do you think this bill stands, or your thoughts on this and what you would like to have for schools?
We've got 13 days left in the legislative session, and I really believe that this is one thing that should transcend politics. It's not a Republican-Democrat thing. It's about our most important responsibility is keeping our citizens safe, and particularly, you know, our vulnerable kids. I mean, no parent should be worried about whether their child's coming home from school.
We're talking with Governor Larry Hogan, who is here in studio. Obviously, the mandate to start school after Labor Day, and we've had a lot of days off because of the weather. And some people have pointed out because it's so tough to get an extension now that this policy isn't working. Do you have any second thoughts about that, or at least lessening up or the strict rules when it comes to expanding the school year?
Yeah, I think this is an unusual year in that the calendar, just by the nature of the calendar, was shorter and made it tougher. And we had snow days here in the spring that we weren't expecting. We also had days in places like Baltimore City where they closed the schools because they had no heat working and issues like that. So, yeah, we'd like to give flexibility so that they can add, you know, those days and make up 3 to 5 days, whatever it is. But the policy itself, a commission set up by the legislature studied this for a year, was made up of administrators, school administrators, teachers, parents, experts in education. They voted 13-2 to set school after Labor Day. Previous governor was in favor of it, both speaker and the president of the Senate was. And, you know, 86% of the people in Maryland are in favor of starting school after Labor Day, so that policy is not going to change.
All right, last question for all this, guys. I know you've been, you talked tough about what's going on in Washington, D.C., and as you well know, Democrats try to pin everything Donald Trump does on you. And you talked about, you know, redistricting and making these congressional primaries more competitive for both Democrats yeah. and Republicans, no matter what state you are in. Having said that, there is a proposal in Maryland for open primaries. Is that something that you would be in favor of?
I think it's worth considering. I mean, that's, you know, a lot of people don't get the opportunity to vote. We have a large independent population that's not registered or kind of frustrated with Democrats and Republicans, and maybe we ought to consider giving them a shot. But this nonpartisan redistricting is really a key issue. I think that's part of the reason we have such divisiveness in Washington and in Annapolis. And this Wednesday, tomorrow, actually, that we have the Supreme Court hearing a Maryland case that I think is going to potentially change the way we do business in the country.
Potential. So you're not.
I can't. I'm not a constitutional scholar, and I can't guess what the folks down there are going to do. But it's a good case, and people really have been disenfranchised, and most people want free and fair elections and nonpartisan drawing of lines.
All right. I know you got to run. Appreciate you coming in. Hope to see you down the road sometime.
Hey, thank you so much, Ryan. Appreciate it.
And Governor Larry Hogan here on WBAL News Radio 1090.